Good evening, everybody. Well, thank you for having invited us again. Well, actually, to Mr. Kostas Nostis to have invited us here again after 1 year. And actually, we are realizing that this Infocom is becoming a traditional now rendezvous even for our company. I'm very glad that I'm here and have the possibility to speak with you, because the main purpose of our intervention is actually to share some experience we've been having in a market that is similar to the one we have in Greece. And this is the Italian market, that it is similar in terms of media market, but also from a political point of view, or let's say from an economic point of view, we are quite close. So we do know that nowadays we have, a crisis period that we are passing over both of our countries. And this is clearly a tough period for everybody, but it is also time for opportunities the way we see it, especially at the group level. And I'm saying that because what we discover, what are the main reasons that we see behind these problems that especially broadcasters are experiencing in our market in Italy, is linked to the two main items. The first one being the economic downturn, and the second one is the increased competition that is coming from new players, as I'm imagining is coming. Is entering also in Greece. And we think that we should resist, and this is the message we're trying to convey to all the industry, we should resist the shrinking our ambitions, our goals. We should leverage on added value to maintain differentiating factors so that we at least manage to maintain shares, market shares that we already had in the market before the entrance of new players. And we're doing that mainly with two actions. The first action is to be together with the industry. And we do that participating in first line with innovation. And this innovation actually starts at different stages. It starts at the stages of industry, let's say, content producers or aggregating new contents. As you know, we have we are on the front line of promoting new standards of quality, the ultra high definition. We have been the first operator in Europe that is experimenting the new HEVC codec, let's say, compression on satellites, because we understand that quality is good, quality can be a differentiating factor for our customers, but it's nothing if you do not make it as a viable commercial opportunity. So we need to find also solutions that stand alone, that are in line with the business plan. This is the first one we're doing on the so-called 4K. We also are working on interoperability. I couldn't follow most of what was discussed before because my Greek is poor, is really poor, it's nil actually. But I understood that also in Greece we are moving towards more domestic application for TV. And we have partnered with the industry to create a new standard that works to have direct provision of satellite signals into IP. And this is extremely important when you want to facilitate mobility, especially in domestic areas. And when we normally, I think that the OTT representative said before that OTT is one of the items that is being carefully listened to at the moment. But most of the time, as it is happening also in Italy, for example, Sky Italia, if they want to to improve or to deliver also OTT services in mobility, they normally go via internet. And as you know, normally internet is one of the bottleneck to have a good service. Our solution just bypass internet, and we directly from the reception of the satellite dish, we introduce these contents in the IP network of the house, maybe through Wi-Fi or dedicated Ethernet lines. And so this is just to show you that we're not just proposing ourselves as capacity operator, especially during time of crisis. There is another solution, and this will be more the object of my presentation today, that is the hybrid solution. But this is just to tell you that we think that the main role of everybody in this industry should be to try to see to increase the cake of the market. And then only afterwards we can start talking of revenues and shares. And this is what we've been doing now in Italy, where we are supporting the public broadcaster Rai. We have to say that it took us a while, because in Italy, for different reasons, some ones you can clearly understand, up to a few months ago, it was not possible or not even envisageable to talk of free-to-air HD transmission. So thanks to us, things are changing radically, and Rai will soon have a bouquet in HD, and this will be mainly thanks to the effort we have been putting in the market. So let me just start by providing you very few figures of what we are and what we do. So you know that we are a world satellite operator, in the sense that we have a truly global coverage that can be interesting for our broadcaster when they ask us to deliver also new services for different markets, and not only national markets. We have experienced that also in Italy, that in time of crisis, broadcasters tend to go abroad to find new opportunities. And we are, of course, amongst the first ones. It depends on which ratio you look at, but if you look at the EBITDA or other type of financial indicators, we're really on the top line. So this is, in a nutshell, the main elements of our, of our DNA at the moment. So as I said before, a global fleet of 54 satellites. We've just been informed by Ariane Space that they made us a Christmas gift by anticipating the launch of the next satellite that was foreseen for later on, but instead will be launched on the 5th of December. So this means another satellite in operation by the end of the year. And with a coverage of 99% of the world's population, this is extremely important when you deliver as a main focus of your activity the DTH services, and this is what we're doing at the moment. 276 million households all over the world, with a very big chunk of these ones reached in Europe. Then it's not only satellite assets that we put that we offer our customer, is a, most of the case, is a turnkey solution that also leverage on a widespread teleport network structure. We are the leading DTH operator in Europe. We are the ones that are delivering the most number of HD channels, for example, the TV channel in general, but also HD channels. As I said before, innovation for us is a way to move forward, and the number of HD channels we deliver in Europe is more than what our major competitors can do by adding up their signal. So we're really on the front end of quality and innovation. Over 6,000 TV channels. And then also we are hosting some of the fastest growing DTH platforms. There are, well, Italy is quite a mature market, I have to say, although there are some margin for improvements, especially leveraging on quality, as I said before. But there are other areas, like we have in east of Europe, or other areas that are fast developing nowadays, like in India. India is really booming up with the number of the DTH subscription, and the pay TV operator or free-to-air operator are just experiencing, as you maybe know, very good success. Our staff is substantial, over 1,000 employees. And then we have 22 locations worldwide. Our location, our office, commercial office in Rome, takes care, as you have understood after all these years, of Italy and also Greece. So this is, as I said, the chart that shows the coverage of our satellites, 54 satellites, and the clustered zone that you see over there. I just want to move over there, but you can see that at 19.2 and also at 23.5, towards the center of the figure, there are this clustered area where we provide mainly DTH services with a high reliable service. The clustered areas means that we provide a very high backup service also on to counteract satellite failure. So these are the numbers I've mentioned before, 6,000 TV channels worldwide. It's quite an impressive number, I have to say. 276 million homes around the globe, and this number is expanding very fast, especially in the former called BRIC countries, especially in India. And also East is coming forwards quite interesting. South America is also another interesting market. For example, Mexico, as you may have followed, have reached 18 million with one of the pay TV operators, 18 million of subscribers via satellite. So these are the major, let's say, the segmentation we do of our services, and these are the major one we, I would say that they have been listed in order of importance for us, or at least importance of focusing. So we have direct-to-home services, cable distribution. This is also a substantial part of our services. For example, in Germany, that is our hotspot in Europe, we have a high number of households that are served by cable, but still illuminated by satellite. Then full-time contribution, contribution sometimes can be also occasional use on a longer term, but most of the time it's full-time contribution. And then digital terrestrial TV. So, as I said before, it is not just satellite capacity. As you can see here, we have a list of services we can provide a la carte or on the same approach, and that we use to integrate our offer, not to integrate vertically. It's rarely that we integrate vertically to include services that are normally out of our core business. But sometimes when we have been requested, we do that. When it is required, when we think that the market needs development, we even invest in the market and we play really in the front, like as we did in South Africa to create a second pay TV bouquet. But most of the time we are a neutral approach as a satellite operator. These are a very short selection of our most famous, not the most valuable, but most famous customer that we have, that with their signals can reach our satellites or our neighborhood. And this is the solution that actually I have already mentioned to you last year, or it was something very similar to that. The reason why we are proposing that instead of concentrating on DTH like we are doing at the moment in Italy. In Italy, what we are trying to do, as I said before, is to create a second platform that can be the platform, the elected platform for quality. So high definition, also ultra high definition. We have channels that have already started to broadcast at 19.2, also in ultra high definition. This is what we're doing because this is we think can be the difference we play in the market, or our customer can play in the market to compete with the new players. The reason why I concentrated on this solution is because we, in Italy, we have switched over from analog to digital network in June of 2012, so last year. Everything seems to have gone well, more or less, in the sense that, I mean, there are still some areas where SFN is creating problems in echoing, so the coverage is not as it was before. We do not official figures are not are below 90% of the population that is covered with the new digital network. But still, we have helped the market to compensate or to support during this transitional phase in two ways. One way was to complement the digital terrestrial transmission by providing services via satellite. And indeed, there is a new service in Italy called TVSat, where we have a number of subscribers. I call them subscribers, but they do not pay. And this is in the order of 2 million subscribers in over 3 years. It's quite an interesting number. And the other solution is to provide the carrier operators, so those that have to move and upgrade from analog frequencies to digital frequencies, by feeding the different towers via a satellite contribution link. So the benefits are an immediate coverage, so the timing to roll out this solution is very fast. As I was saying, we managed to do, we will see, we have ranged over a couple of examples, but with this technique you can actually have the rollout of a solution, even in a mountains country like Italy, that is similar to Greece, quite in a reasonable, in a short time. We're talking of 1 quarter, 2-3 months, you can have everything set it up. Then financial benefits is because actually you can save on CapEx, on upfront payment, and this is always interesting in time of crisis when you can move from CapEx to OpEx. That's one of the mantra people or consultants say. And then infrastructure availability, security and reliability. So, because this is one of, I mean, you know how reliable is satellite service, and de facto leveraging on this solution just provide increased reliability of the network. As you see here, we mainly have, the solution can work both for MFN and SFN solution. To tell you the truth, I'm not sure, I do not know what is the regulation that is gonna be applied in Greece, whether some countries, because at the beginning in Italy, the public broadcaster was meant to use MFN, and then all the rest SFN, at the end of the day, to save on frequencies, as it was the, and I think I'm getting already the answer for Greece as well, everything was ruled to be run in SFN. But for the way, I mean, for our system or for our solution, doesn't make really a big difference. So the main element of or the main advantages of a solution of a satellite contribution services via satellites are those that we have listed there. But of course, we are available to provide you further elements if you want on specific items. So, as I said, the satellite footprints, by being ubiquitous, reduce times for the rollout of the solution. Then very reliable satellites. We we keep innovating. 54 satellite is not only to reach new market and expand business, it's also to increase the reliability of the service. And this is why we have clustered areas where we have more than one satellite at orbital location. So leading satellite operator during, I mean, this time financial stability is something that is sort of evaporating, but for us, thanks God, is still one of the assets that we managed to have. And then teleport contribution services as a contributing factor to the turnkey solution, as I said before. So this is the satellite we are using for Italy, Astra 1G at 31.5 degrees east. And it is, well, if you see northeast, is no, northwest, sorry, of Italy, the Turin area, to be clearer, it's not very well covered, at least from the spot beam, but still, we managed to have a good national coverage with this satellite by just increasing a little bit the size of the antenna. So all the system that we have deployed in Italy works on the basis of 90 centimeter antenna, and on that area that I mentioned before, we have installed 120 centimeter antenna. So having said that, Greece is, I think, is very well suited for having a very good service on this satellite. It's even more centered than what we have in Italy. And on top of that, the new satellite Astra 5B that will be soon replacing this satellite is really even more powerful than the figures you see there. Here it is. It's even more shifted, if you may allow me, towards east. So really, the whole Greece is included in the coverage, and it's well covered. If you see 52 dB watts, is quite good. So just as a couple of slides, we're almost over, so don't you worry. Couple of slides where we tell you of these carriers. We prefer to keep them confidential, but still we can tell you that they are national digital carriers that are operating new digital frequencies, and they had this strong and stringent requirements to have a reliable service to be implemented in a short while. We did that at the moment for three. There are others that are planning, that are asking us to come on board. Of course, we're willing to do that, but we need to get prepared to that. We were not expecting such a demand or such a success, to be honest. And this is the scheme is pretty simple. So from the national DTT carriers, you have the uplink to the satellite. Most of the case, instead of uplinking directly from the DTT, from the broadcaster operational premises, we fiber contribute, or we even go via optical link to the teleport. We have a teleport in Italy dedicated for us. Actually, there is another one that is going to sign with us very soon. And then we uplink on the satellites. We distribute on the different towers. And then from the towers, the signal via hertzial link goes to the final user. So because of that, for us, this is the main leitmotif of my story. Because of that, not only because of us, but let's say because of this harmonic development that we managed to install in the Italian market, figures are still increasing for audience, or let's say number of households that are looking at TV channels. So you see the share between digital and analog televisions. And then you have the number in millions of terrestrial homes. So this is for terrestrial reception. We have, I think it's more than 15 million households that are receiving signal in DTT. And then these channels are served via satellite. out of these 15, on top of these 15, we have another 8 million that are served by satellites, for a total of 24, roughly, million households that look at, I mean, that are the consumer or the user of our market. This we said, this is the conclusions, or as I said, this is the DTT, the feeding of a DTT network with the help of a satellite helps in having a I don't know if this is the right word, the capillary distribution, let's say very extended DTT distribution, so you can save in part of the complexity of the network, and this saves in costs and money. And on top of that, there are possibility, and this is something that is could be interesting for some broadcast that also have an interest to access satellite segment, that we, you or us, we use the same segment that is normally used for feeding the towers, the TTT towers, also to access DTH market. So with just one space segment, you have double use. You go to the towers, then the towers go to the different satellite, to the terrestrial homes, or you go directly to the, or at the same time, you can go directly to the satellite homes. I think this should be it. We are available for further questions, even now if you want, or we should be around until the end of the day.
Thank you.
Thank you.